Hello viewers, welcome to the Power BI course. Today we are going to learn three time intelligence DAX functions, which are parallel period, date add, and same period last year. Now I chose these three functions in one video because they all have a similar results. However, they have a subtle differences as well. So I want you to learn by looking the results side by side, and so you can understand where and when to use which function. So let's start from their syntax. So as you can see here on parallel period, it's looking for a date, then number of intervals, and interval. Now date column, so we are going to use our calendar table. And before we move on, I would like to mention here that you need to get a date table from your database. If you do not have that, then you need to create a date table to use these time intelligence functions, because it needs a continuous date without any break. And so we cannot rely on our order date or ship date available in our data, okay? So if you wanted to learn how to create a date table, then I have two videos on that. I'm going to link it in the description, how to create a date table using DAX and how to create a date table using M language in Power Query, okay? So you can create your date table and then you can use these time intelligence functions. Now, so come back to the syntax here, that parallel period is looking for a date. Number of interval, meaning you can give a minus for the previous years, or you can give a positive number for like future number of year, okay, or month. So if you use a minus, then if you use let's say minus one, then it gives you previous, and then if you chose interval as a year, then previous year, previous quarter, or previous month, it gives you a result that way. And so you can choose in parallel period, you can choose your number of intervals and interval itself. Okay, so that is one thing for the parallel period. Now on date add, same thing, same syntax. It looking for a date, which is our calendar date column. Then you're going to enter here a number of interval, and you're going to choose year, quarter, month. But in this case, on date add, it also allows you to choose a day, so it can compare the day result as well, where here it only year, quarter, and month, okay? And then same period last year syntax, it's only looking for a dates. And it mentioned on their website that it using this fixed number of interval and interval, which we are not allowed to change. So it basically same period last year is always giving you a last year comparison. Okay, so that is the difference between syntax, and this is the difference you can see in the result as well. Okay, so let's get started here, and I'm going to open up Power BI. I already have a matrix here where I use my calendar year hierarchy, which has all three in the hierarchy: year, quarter, and month. Okay, and then we have our sales data, where I have my total sales measure, which has a simply, I'm using a sum function to sum my sales amount. Okay, so this is that is this result, the simple measure. Okay, now we are going to create a measure for all the three functions. Now these functions, these all functions, they give you only a single column, which is a date column. So it returns a single column of dates based on your whatever you choose here. Okay, so we need sum of sales as well to create a measure. Okay, so I'm going to click on new measure, and my measure name is date add. So my measure name is date add. And we are going to use a calculate function. We have to use calculate function because calculate function is allowing us to use our expression against the filter. Okay. So I'm going to use my total sales measure here and then comma. Now our filter where we are going to use these functions. Okay. So date add and date add is looking for date and then interval, which is in, I wanted to use -1, which is previous one, and then previous 1 year. So basically I'm trying to say here that give me a last year like comparison. Okay. And then I'm going to close the bracket and our measure is ready. Now we are going to create another measure for parallel period and my I have to use a calculate function for my measure total sales comma and parallel period, and that is also looking for date column, so our calendar date. And then -1, and then again I'm going to choose a year. It gives me 3 options. Okay. And close bracket and enter our, and my third measure is same period last year and calculate for my total sales comma. I have to use a same period last year function, and it is only looking for a date, so calendar date. Okay, and bracket close. Now I'm going to use all these 3 measures side by side. So our total sales we have, and now a date add we have, parallel period we have, and same period last year we have. Okay. So everything together, as you can see by year, they all are matching with each other. Date add, parallel period, and same period last year. While this one is our current data. So it makes sense that 2011, the total sales is this. And it exactly number shows here on 2012. So from 2012 point of view, the previous year data is that. 2013 then data this, and 2014 this. Okay. So now if I click on this little expand all down one level hierarchy button, and we can see here we have our quarterly data. So as you can see here that the date add shows the quarter by quarter data. So Q1 comparison, Q2 comparison, Q3 comparison, and Q4. Okay. And same period last year as well shows a same number of data. However, the parallel period showing me total year sales for all 4 quarters. Okay, so that is the difference between two. Now let's try to put it parallel period. We had an option to choose a quarter as well, right? So I'm going to use a quarter option and enter. So now it shows me a quarterly data, but it shows like this one is starting in the next year, where parallel period is starting just after the quarter, but it shows quarterly data. Okay. Now if I break down further by month, let's see what happens. Then the parallel period again shows quarterly data only, and the same period last year and the date add shows the monthly data as well. You can see our January Q1 2011 193305, and here you can see 193305. Okay, so it shows that data. However, parallel period does not show. If you change it by month, it will show. So basically, I'm trying to say that this is the difference, that in parallel period, you need to change the right interval. Then only you can see the right data. Okay, now it shows. Okay, now my hierarchy doesn't have a day, so I'm going to add a date there. So I wanted to expand it up to date level. Okay, and I'm going to click on again this button, and we have now date level total sums. And again, the parallel period, it's showing up a monthly data. Now, in case of parallel period, I told here that we have a breakdown up to month. So you can get a year, quarter, and month. You do not have a day there. However, date add has a date level data. Okay. So we have our first date in 2011, 1st January, 6085839, that number. And let's see what our date add function gives us. So yeah, that exactly the number we have. And that same period last year as well have that. So basically same period last year is very simple, straightforward function, which does not allow us to change interval and number of intervals. However, it works well. And date add, you need to give that and then it works. But the parallel period, it only breaks down up to a month. So it gives you option to change up to year or quarter or month. Okay. So that is the difference between three. Now you know with all details. So you can use wherever you wanted to use the right function. So this is all about these three functions in this video, guys. If you like the content, then please comment, like, share, and subscribe my channel. And if you do not like, then also give me a feedback so I can make my videos better. Okay, thanks for watching.